And we want to work on the horizontal menu now. So here is the make it look like this file. We're going to use float for the top four, which we've used before, so it's a good review. And on the bottom one, we're going to use the display and inline property and value. So it's a couple of new things. Let's look at the HTML. And you can see here we have a UL class of nav primary. It's been clear fixed. And inside that, we have some LIs. Then we have a UL class of nav secondary. And inside that, we have some LIs. So let's begin with our CSS. Here it is up here. Creating the contextual selector of the class, which is nav primary, and the child of it is the li. So let's just give it the float left. And just a reminder, the nav primary is the class, so it begins with a dot. And the child of nav primary is the li tag, so there's just a space between them. We'll do a save, and let's go to the HTML and see what that looks like. And here it is. So we did get them side by side. Let's take the bullets off. Let's do that quickly. Go over to the CSS. So again, I'm going to type a contextual selector, nav primary. And this time I'm working on my UL, right? Because I'm going to get the bullets off. So this is list style none. Save and refresh. Ooh, nothing happened. Nothing happened. Let's look at the HTML, see if we can figure it out. So as I pointed out earlier, the li is a child of the UL. But if we look at this UL, it is a UL with a class called navPrimary. So UL is not a child of navPrimary. UL has a class on it of navPrimary. So there's a different way to write that out, and it's simply changing the order here. I'm going to cut that and put it right in front of the dot with no space at all. So what I'm saying is my UL has a class of navPrimary. Let's do a save and a refresh, and now the dots are gone. So it would be great if this horizontal rule hadn't jumped up here, but it did because, as you know, the li has floated away, and so it's horizontal rule has jumped up in its place. And you know the easy fix to that is the clear fix. So let's go grab the clear fix from here. And it's at the top. I'll just copy it. Control C, Command C. And then I'm gonna come back down to my horizontal menu styles, and I will put it up here. So there is my class of ClearFix, and now I need to add it to the HTML. I see that there's already a class on the navPrimary UL, so I'm just going to skip a space and put the ClearFix in here. This is the proper syntax for HTML attribute tags. And I'll do a save and a refresh. And there it is. Now let's see if we can make this look right. Here's what it's supposed to look like. We're gonna need some gray boxes around here. And it looks like there's some padding around them and some margin between them. The last gray that we used was 666, hashtag 666. And the grays are typically, if it's gonna be displayed on white, it's usually the CCC. And if it's gonna be displayed on black, like it was last time, it's usually 666. So let's give that a try. And we'll be doing it to not just the top list, but to the bottom list too, because they both need this. Let's create an A tag for those lists. And it's gonna have a border. I'm gonna use the shortcut rule here so that I only have to type border once. It'll be 1px and solid and the gray that I named CCC. And what did I say, padding? So I'll do padding of 1em. Save and refresh. All right, that's good. I didn't add the margin yet, so we need to add that space, but it's looking good. I'll add the space, and let's add it to the A tag. And I'm going to make that 1em as well. Save and refresh. Ooh. That is not quite what I was hoping for. It looks like, see, this is my, and then the bot blog, and then these are overlapping. It's not quite right. I suspect that that is because the browser is reading the A tag as an inline element. So just to test my theory, I'm going to add an LI tag, and I'm going to put that here. Because the LI tag is a block level element. Let me do a save and refresh. Oh yeah, that's better. In order to test my theory and to help you understand the difference between styling inline and block level elements, I want to teach you a tag. I think we visited it once before. I'm going to actually put this back. And then I'm going to add display block. So what this is saying is to the browser, please display my A tags as a block level element. And if that works, I'll know that I was right in my assumption. Save and refresh. Oh, much better. So you can see how display block works. The A element is an inline element. And I wanted it to be displayed as a block level element so that I could put some padding on it. Now let's take a look at this bottom nav. It looks like this. Let me just stretch it. So you can see these bars, as I move my browser window, they get longer or shorter. And they look like this for two reasons. The first reason is that we've got four LI items. Let's look at that right here. We've got four LI items, oops, down here. And an LI item is a block level item, so it's gonna naturally stack one on top of the other. I mean, that's what a list is about, right? Second, you can see that the box around this, which is styled in my A tag, there's the border box. It is stretching all the way out, and that's because I've asked it to display as a block level element. So those two problems are easily remedied, as is the problem of the bullets on the list. So let's take care of the bullets on the list first. I've got this list style type none set up for the nav primary, but I also want it to happen on the nav secondary, right? So I'm just going to take this off. Save and refresh. There it is. That's that. Now I want to create on the LIs a new tag called display inline block. Let's see what that looks like. Save and refresh. Holy cow. Gosh, that was a lot easier, wasn't it, than all the work that we had to do with floats? No clear fix. Nothing. Just easy. All right, so let's make a mental note that you'll help you understand this. I'm going to open up my inspector so that we can talk a little bit about this and the links inside the LI items. If I were to uncheck this display block on my A tag, look what happens. So why does that happen? It happens because as soon as those A's are no longer block level, the surrounding LI tag, and thus the UL2, does not really understand how much space they're taking up with their extra margin and padding. It's only seeing the text to determine the height of those A's, so it makes the LIs think that they're not holding as much as they are. Anyway, we've got this set now. Let's move on with the real week 11 lab.